Welcome to this video on constructions. In our previous video, we learned the construction of a triangle with a given base side, a base angle, and the sum of the other two sides. In this session, we will learn to construct a triangle whose base side, a base angle, and the difference of the other two sides is given. Here, in case 1, we will see where the side constructed on the base angle is big. So let's see how we will construct a triangle with the given measures. For example, suppose we have to construct a triangle PQR, the length of whose base side QR is given, the measure of the base angle Q is given, and the difference of the other two sides PQ minus PR is given. Friends, can you tell what is the difference between PQ minus PR and PR minus PQ? We know that in order to find the difference always, the smaller side is deducted from the larger side. Hence, we can understand that if the value of PQ minus PR is given, then in such a case, side PQ is big and the side PR is smaller. Similarly, if the value of PR minus PQ is given, then the length of the side PR will be big and the length of the side PQ will be small. And friends, as per the difference given in the sides, the construction of a triangle is done in two ways. Case 1, the side drawn on the base angle is big, PQ greater than PR, that is PQ minus PR is given. Or case 2, the side drawn on the base angle is small, PQ lesser than PR, that is PR minus PQ is given. In this video, we will learn the construction with the information given in case 1. Then suppose that we want to construct the triangle PQR, where the base side is QR, the information about PQ minus PR is available, and the measure of angle Q is known. And the steps for the construction of such a triangle are as follows. Step 1. First of all, we will draw the base side QR with the help of a scale. Step 2. With the help of a protractor, we will construct the given angle Q, and from point Q, we will draw a ray QX. Step 3. From ray QX, cut a line segment equal to PQ minus PR, which is equal to the measure of the difference of the length of the two sides, and name this point of intersection as S. Step 4. Now join point S to point R. Step 5. Next, with the help of a compass, we will draw the perpendicular bisector of side SR. We have learned about the construction of a perpendicular bisector in the first session of the construction topic. Step 6. We can see that the perpendicular bisector line TU is intersecting ray QX, and we will represent this point of intersection as P. Thus, friends, the constructed triangle PQR is the same triangle which we wanted to construct. Here, you can see that side PQ is greater than side PR, and the difference of PQ minus PR is represented by QS. Well, friends, this work doesn't end just here. Now, we will check the construction of the constructed triangle. We have to prove that the length of SQ is equal to PQ minus PR. So let's prove that triangle PQR is the required triangle. Point P is equidistant from point S and point R because this point is the point that is located on the bisector of the side SR. Therefore, PS is equal to PR. Let's call it equation 1. And side PQ is formed by joining two line segments PS and SQ. Therefore, PQ is equal to PS plus SQ. And we can write it like this as well. SQ is equal to PQ minus PS. Using equation 1, we can write it as follows. SQ is equal to PQ minus PR. That is, the length of side SQ is equal to PQ minus PR. Therefore, our construction is correct. So friends, let's end this video here. Today, we learned the construction of a triangle given the base side, a base angle, and the difference of the other two sides. See you in the next video with a question related to this construction. Thank you.